Aero3D selective powder deposition is a 3D printing process which you can use to print metal, ceramic and glass. There are two main variants, infilling and sintering. With infilling, you get a 100% solid object. And with sintering, you get a porous object. Here is how it works. First, you selectively pour, build and support powders into a crucible. When you finish filling the whole crucible, you add some infill material, and to create a reducing atmosphere, you add some coke, close the lid, and bake it in a kiln. The temperature in the kiln should be above the melting temperature of the infill, but below the melting temperature of the powders. When the infill melts, it soaks the build powder, but it doesn't soak the support powder, because the support powder is not wettable by the infill. When it cools down, remove it from the kiln and clean it with a wire brush. The second variant, sintering, is even simpler. You just don't add any infill and bake it at the temperature sufficient to sinter the build powder. Note that when you use sintering, the object will shrink and will get distorted. By changing the baking temperature, you can influence the amount of shrinkage, distortion and porosity, but it will never be 100% solid. This variant is useful if you want to obtain a porous object, to make a filter, for example. But if you want a 100% solid object, with no shrinkage, no distortion, and no porosity, use the first variant, the infill. In theory, SPD can be used to print almost any material. Actually, the printer itself is material agnostic, and can pour any powder that flows through a small hole. But when it comes to baking, some materials are easier than others. For the full list, see aero3d.com.